Lost World, the Jurassic Park for Sega Saturn, is a game that uses the Jurassic Park license to make a side-scrolling game featuring dinosaurs. You do get to play as a human dinosaur hunter, or just a human civilian for a few levels, but the game's main playable characters are two-footed prehistoric creatures. You start out the game as a tiny Compsognathus. These are like, those are the little creatures that killed, you know, one of the guys in the movie. They group up and they just like start biting it. They're like this big, you know. They're tiny. They're like this big, but then they all group together and they kill one of the main characters. But anyway, this tiny Compsognathus you play as, that you start out playing as, and you chirp at little creatures of your size, or you run away from bigger beasts. After 10 escapist adventures, you get to try out the Velociraptor. Then you shoot some stuff as a human dinosaur hunter. Then the levels of the game feature the infamous Tyrannosaurus Rex, which, while slow, has devastating and chilling power, as you might expect. The final levels as a human civilian, the final levels are as a human running away from an angry T-Rex, and that makes for a really fun finale to the game. It's not much, but the game is really fairly enjoyable. The levels where you play as the inflexible and vulnerable human hunter, they're the tedious levels, and rather boring. But overall, the novelty of playing as a T-Rex is actually much more satisfying than you'd think. Ironically though, to me, the best levels were the ones where you played as the powerless Compsognathus. I mean, those levels just offer just pure escapist thrill. There's a level where you're in the middle of a Brontosaurus stampede. There's a humongous herd of Brontosauruses, and you have to kind of dodge their footsteps. You know, your tiny little creature, and these creatures are like, what? I don't know, they're pretty big. They're like the size of, 10 times the size of elephants. And they're humongous. And they're all like running, you know, they're walking, and you have to kind of dodge their footsteps. That level, amazing, amazing stuff. There's a lot of platforming with Compsognathus. And the finale of Compsognathus is you're swimming in water. And you have to find a lot of bubble pieces, the bubble places to kind of keep your breath. But at the same time, there are these humongous prehistoric alligators roaming around, so you kind of just kind of dodge them around. I mean, Compsognathus levels is a lot like Frogger. You know, you're vulnerable. You're gonna die with like one hit from anything. You encounter Velociraptor, you're dead. But it's really about, you know, trying to figure out where to go, how to get there, how to escape. That escapist thrill, Compsognathus level is just awesome. And then the Velociraptor levels are more of your, it's more typical level where you have powers. You know, you claw, you bite, and you're pretty agile and fast. You know, you kind of think Velociraptors are pretty fun. T-Rex are just novelty levels, really. T-Rex levels, really, there isn't much of a strategy, there isn't much of a puzzle, there isn't much platforming. You just got this humongous T-Rex, and you just mow down everything in sight, and you just kind of eat people to get your health back up, and you claw the people, so that's pretty fun. Human levels are, the human hunter level is the most difficult one. You have a grappling hook that you kind of just swing past by, and you shoot dinosaurs. These headbutter dinosaurs, I forgot the name of them, but they're the most annoying because they take a lot of bullets to kill. And the human levels are just so boring. The finale levels, where you're a human civilian running away from T-Rex, it's just so much fun. So this really, this whole game is really just has like about 40 levels total, including all those 5 playable characters. Aside from, you know, the human level, the hunter levels were the only levels I really didn't like because it was tedious. The controls were kind of stiff, especially the shooting, jumping, and platforming with Hunter is just, it's just bad. Compared, you know, because you get so used to jumping agile as a Velociraptor and this Compsognathus, it's no longer fun to be as a human hunter. But the levels are really just a lot of fun. But I guess once after you're done with them, it's pretty much it. The game, that's pretty much it. All the levels, you will get through this game like, what, 2 hours, 3 hours, and then you're done with it. But it's fun while it lasts. I mean, it's a very novel concept to play as dinosaurs. I mean, I never really thought I would have that much fun playing as a helpless creature. I thought I'd be more excited to play as a T-Rex. And that's one of the marketing aspects. You look at the game's back of the case, and it's like, play as a T-Rex! That's the marketing aspect. But really, the best part of the game is playing as the human civilian running away from T-Rex, jumping, shooting flares, trying to survive, and also the very first parts of the game where you have this tiny little creature trying to survive.